So for today's video, I'm going to be showing you some school life hacks because I know going back to school can be hard and I just want to make it as easy for you guys as possible. So basically, I went online, I tried to find a bunch of cool life hacks that I hadn't seen a ton of places before. I also tried to throw in some stuff that I've come up with on my own, so I'm going to be showing you guys how to do all of those. So anyways, if you're new here, be sure to click that subscribe button down below. And if you'd like to, I'm having a giveaway going on right now where you can potentially win a backpack, a tapestry, and Beats headphones. So if you want to enter that, I'll have all the information down below, but the main rule is that you have to be a subscriber, so be sure to do that. And yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get started. I hope you guys enjoy the video, and let's get to it.
Also, you guys, my friends Karina, Chrissy, and Brylin are all doing school supplies videos as well, so definitely check them out. So our first hack is a desk hack, which is so helpful because these school desks are way too tiny. All you need are some binder clips and rubber bands. So you want to attach the binder clips to the side of the desk and then just put some rubber bands on your school supplies. And this is perfect because you can get your stuff out of the way while you're working, but grab it really easily if you need to. All right, I'm sure a few of you already do this, but I used to do this a lot during high school. Don't tell my mom. But basically, you can use the back of your calculator as kind of like a phone case, and that way your teacher can't see you using your phone. I know this makes me slightly a bad influence, but it is helpful if you need to use it. So this is my helpful study hack for you guys. Basically, I know color association is not like a new study technique, but a lot of times when I try to implement it, I forget what colors I've like assigned different subjects. So my tip for you is to print them out on sticker paper and label your highlighters. That way when you're using them, you won't forget and it will help you remember things for tests. So when I was in high school, the cool thing was shoulder bags. I swear I'm not that old, but basically everyone liked them, but they hurt your shoulder. So if you have one and you just need a shoulder break, you can unlatch the hook and stick it through the top handles. This kind of creates a fake backpack, and I know it looks a little silly, but it really does help out your shoulders if they're aching. So hopefully this helps some of you guys. So in high school, like before school, I would always go get Starbucks, and then I had like a study hall so I could still have it, but I always wanted somewhere to put my drink but not on the floor, so you can actually stick it in that top part of your backpack and it holds it pretty well. So I have another desk space saving hack for you, and this is just to kind of help you organize everything but still be able to access it, and you'll be able to see what I mean in just a second. So for this you need some like mason jars or whatever kind of jars you like. I just got a few different size ones, and then I got this kitchen turntable from Bed Bath & Beyond. I think it was like $7, and basically it spins around so you can reach everything without having to get up. I know this is like for really lazy people, but sometimes you just are working, you don't want to be moving around a ton. I know it's kind of bad, but whatever. It's really helpful, and that way you can use all of your stuff and have it in one space. So this is kind of like a time hack, I guess. This helped me out. I'm just like really a visual person, and sometimes you spend all of your time and you don't really realize like how it's being allocated. So this is to kind of help you visualize what you're doing in the afternoon. So you just need some markers, and you can open your clock and actually like draw on the face if you want. But I actually like doing it on the like plastic part because you can wipe it off if you want to change it. So I am just kind of like making different portions for different like activities. Outside of school. So like maybe from 4 to 5 you have sports, and then like from 5 to 5:30 you have like internet. It just kind of helps you make sure that you're spending your time and not wasting a ton of it. So this is really helpful. So in high school, I had to like pack my gym clothes, my books, everything, and a lot of times it just didn't really fit that well in my backpack. So I'm gonna show you a little space saving hack. You can roll up your clothes and then actually just stick it in a gym sock, and this way you have all of your stuff in one spot and it's like really consolidated. I'm struggling today. It kind of just looks like you put a Chipotle burrito in a sock, but it does keep everything organized and it is really helpful. All right, this is a headphone hack. It's kind of hard to explain, and I'm already bad at explaining things, so I'm a little worried, but basically you want to stick your pointer finger out, and then at the bottom you've got like the phone part, and then the other side you've got the earbuds. So you're making kind of like a figure eight around your pointer finger and your thumb, and you just want to do that until you run out of the headphone strand. Then you can just pinch the center piece, and you want to slowly just like ease it off of your hands. This is probably the most difficult part, and then you can take that remaining piece and just wrap it around the center and tuck it in. And just to show you guys what it looks like when you uncoil it, basically you just pull that last piece back out and then it unravels and there are no tangles. Okay, so this last one is how to make your own little dry erase board. All you need is an old DVD case, and then you can take out whatever paperwork is in it. And then basically, you can just write on it, and it erases just fine. I think you could probably do this with the cover of your binder too, but I like this just because it's really small. And I think this would be helpful to like test your friends, like with vocabulary or something like that when you're preparing for a test.
So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions about anything, be sure to leave them down below, and we'll see you later. Bye!